our department has really developed a niche for doing research on understanding whether our environment is healthy and whether the environment is contributing to diseases that people really care about. My lab is focused on understanding how diseases like breast cancer might be starting because of chemicals that we're exposed to in the womb.
Air pollution kills somewhere between 6 and 7 million people per year across the planet. And this is a profound public health hazard. We're quite worried about how this interacts with humans and human development. The vast majority of our effort is based on instrument development, working in the developing world, building cohorts and capacity for measuring air pollution, and trying to identify the causes of what parts of air pollution are most toxic for you and I.
We're a developmental toxicology lab. We use the zebrafish model to study how exposure to environmental pollutants can predispose embryos to metabolic dysfunction, diabetes, obesity later on in life.
What my lab is really focusing on is looking at how these environmental factors influence these epigenetic marks in sperm. We're using endocrine disruptors, a class of compounds known to affect hormone levels. We're one of the first studies to look at both paternal and maternal exposures to these compounds.
We're doing cutting-edge research that is interdisciplinary. We're spanning from analytical chemistry to biochemistry, environmental toxicology, and even some environmental epidemiology. So being able to get trained in a very broad range of disciplines really will make for a well-rounded experience that I'd be hesitant to believe you get anywhere else.
We're an innovative group in that we try our hardest to come up with new methods and new science that has never existed before.
This department will drive modern science forward.
We're doing research that's really having an impact, not just in the world of science, but in the world of public health and public good.